Yo, quit video. Like, brothers, don't let any of these women disrespect you. And I cannot stress how much I say this. Don't let them disrespect you. In different forms of life, like resources. If you gotta have a certain amount of money just to get a time of day, like you gotta have six figures and stuff like that just to get a time of day. Don't mess with them. You build yourself up and then you give it to somebody who gonna appreciate you. Or if you're not like a certain type of dude, and you gotta be 2 or 10 times better than certain type of dudes just to get your foot in the door, or just for them to consider giving you the time of day. Don't take that deal. That's disrespectful. Because a relationship like that won't even last. If a chick is not feeling you based on you, not just all the other stuff as well. All the other stuff is important as well, like stability and all that. But if it's not genuine, then the relationship or the potential of that relationship, it's not going to work out. She only there for the superficial shit. Even if she is there for it, she's not willing to build, you know, some type of internal relationship. Build something that's actually genuine. Don't take that deal. That's disrespectful. And, you know, especially if you're a black man, you gotta take damn near everything is disrespectful. Because you gotta want to, hey, would she get with me if I was at the bottom, or if I was just like in the middle? Or, you know, if I'm making my come ups, I'm on my ground making my come ups, will she be there with me to build, stay on my side while I build myself up to get to that golden ticket in life? And, you know, build with each other, build family and stuff like that. A lot of chicks, they don't want to get with a guy that's on the come up. They all about what's, you know, what's now. They don't want to, choose someone before the race starts. They want to wait until the race is finished to choose someone. Don't take that deal. That's disrespectful. And especially if you got to be 2 or 10 times better than certain guys as a black man, depending on the individual that you're trying to shoot your shot at, or you're trying to, you know, get to know, trying to build something with, or you're interested in. I say don't take that deal. That's disrespectful. That's the ultimate disrespect to me as a black man. Especially, I'm gonna bring up Mr. Clean. Yes, I am, because I'm not leaving him off the hook. Because sometimes you gotta be 2 times or 10 times better than him in certain aspects in life just to get a time of day for some of these shits. Especially these non-black shits. Including for some of these daggles, if you're into that market. Personally, I'm not really in that market. I don't even have to deal with, I noticed that brothers, a lot of brothers don't even have to deal with this from white chicks like that. And people say that white women are the most hypergamous women in the country. But a lot of black men can get with white women, and a lot of black men, there's this thing that, you know, Mr. Clean, he has the most resources, but at the end of the day, a lot of brothers can get with a lot of these Melissas and a lot of these Stacys out here who are making average to even slightly above average income. But the Melissa is called the most hypergamous women on the way in America. I mean, I'm not even going to disagree with that, because everybody got their opinions. If you ask me, I personally think that Maylin is the most hypergamous in this country. That's what I personally believe. Like, for the most part, you got to get your shit together. Because a lot of these chicks out here, they got damn bachelors and damn master's degree. Like, how you going to compete with that? And let's not forget about the dating, man. Do not let these women disrespect you in the dating. Meaning, you know, you get overlooked. And some of you get overlooked, or you dealing with individual females who are not black, or everybody else except black. Oh yeah, I almost forgot on my other part. I don't even see a lot of that from Hispanic women. Like, you can be an average to slightly average, a slightly above average brother, and it won't even be problems getting with a lot of these Consuelos and Marias and stuff like that. So I got it pretty good with, you know, with the Melissas, you know, Princess Peaches, and the Marias and Casuelas. A lot of brothers got it good with them, for the most. It's everybody else that's the problem, for the most part. Not all the time, but for the most part. Specifically here in America. But going to my other part about the dating. The dating, don't let these women disrespect you, man, when it comes to the dating. If you're dealing with individual women that throw you under the bus, or what, wouldn't even consider you until the last minute, or until you like the last, you're like the last result, don't take that deal, bro. It's ultimate disrespect as a black man that you have to go through that from an individual who think about you like that. Like, I'm not even worth being the first choice. I have to be the loser choice or the last choice. I say this about the Dabble, for example. Talking all this trash about the heavy male, right? And meanwhile, she thinks Zaddy's ice is colder. So, you know, she getting with Zaddy, and then things didn't work out. She thought the grass was going to be greener on the other side. Nah, it was just straight up chaos on the other side. Now you trying to come back on the dark side now? Now you don't seem to like, oh, I want, you know, every man. A lot of these daggles, bro, they gonna pull that Stacey Dash type shit. Throwing brothers on the bus, talking that shit. Going to the other side, you know, Zaddy, Mr. Clean, and then when it don't work out with Mr. Clean, because Mr. Clean used and abused her, toss her away like a used, threw her in the wash machine like a cum rag, and got another rag. Now she wanna come back to the dark side, to the brothers. Nah, bro, you stay over there with Zaddy. Stay over there. Done did everything. Did all the dirt with him. Did all the slave prey. Probably did ghetto gaggles with him. Everything. Now you wanna come back to the brothers. Nah, bro. Stay over there, or you can get you one of these Fookins and Ray Rays. Or get one of these simp Hoteps, pro blacks. You probably ain't gonna want them, because them dudes worship, most of them are simps. And they make, a lot of them, they make your vaginas dry up like a desert. Daggles don't want those Hotep dudes who, quote unquote, uplift you, say you the goddess. You just use those guys as validations. They turn your vagina into a Yu-Gi-Oh field card with a desert field. You playing on the desert field. All water monsters lose 500 attack points if they on this field. Which is, you know, the Dabble's vagina getting dried up, cause they don't find certain dudes attractive. Nah, bro. And you know, the same thing goes for non-black women too. Other women of color. Same thing goes to them. If a brother wasn't your first choice, or if he was your last choice, you foul, man. And y'all know, I already know how I feel about some of these Malians and shit. Cause I be peeping some of that game, bro. Cause some of them who do get with a brother, some of them, they get with a brother because he was the last choice. Some of these relationships is based on because he was the last choice. Specifically here in America, not all, but some of them did all her dirt, with Mr. Clean, right? Facials probably had trains run on her. I don't heard stories about that too in these little colleges. The Malians out there, they be doing all types of nasty shit with Chad. Getting trains run on them, orgies. Well, the Chad Brad type dudes, even with some of these bottle shelf Waldos. Man, these dudes would nut on a damn egg roll and these bitches would eat that shit. I wouldn't be surprised. These motherfuckers would fart on a damn fortune cookie and them bitches would eat it. I wouldn't be surprised. Cause, you know, all these dudes, they're not going to be, you know, loyal. They just go, some of these dudes, I'm not saying all, but a lot of these dudes, they just look at them as like fetishes, such people to have fun with, women to have fun with, or backup, just in case they can't get, you know, Stacy and Melissa to be on their team. But a lot of times, they just want to use them for sex and shit. Once they get done using them as a cum rag, once they turn their, you know, they get tired of, you know, turning their face, yellow faces into like moon pies, you know, cause, you know, the white marshmallow and then you got the yellow, you know, bread thing between the marshmallow. Kick them to the curb. Now they want, some of them choose to exercise their option. Some of them choose to come to the dark side. And like, nah, man, stay over there. Like, now you want to come to the dark side? Now you want to get Jamal the time of day? Oh, we good, bro. Like, nah, stay over there. Nah, man, you can't come over here. Be day whore. You're either going to have to be day whore or you're going to have to get over that no dating Asian policy. Cause you ain't coming over here. And sometimes, from what I heard from Sunshine Sodas, who actually got experience with that market in the Philippines. He lived in the Philippines. He got tired of rat race. Shout out to Sunshine Sodas. But he told a story one day about how this Filipino chick was talking about, I ain't dating no black man. She was with a rich Filipino dude. Then a couple years, I guess that rich Filipino dude kicked her to the curb and traded her in for a younger, hotter piece. Now that same Filipino chick talking all that shit about how she wouldn't date no black man. Now all of a sudden, ever since she got kicked to the curb, now all of a sudden she want to date a brother. I want to date a black man. Nah, I'm good, bro. I'm Gucci, bro. Be on that damn Jimmy Mai shit. Jimmy Mai shit. Married the mayonnaise guy first and then Dark Meek on the side, right? Man, again, I mentioned this before, but if I was young G's, I would not have taken that deal. Ain't no way in hell I would take some deal like that. She ain't been nobody else but Mr. Clean. Now she want brother when she up in age. Damn near 40 years old. Like, well, she 40. She at least 40, 41, somewhere around there. Ain't no way. Hell no. Nah. And from what I heard from General Tito on his Patreon, some of these Mexican chicks be tripping. I mean, I'm not sure how much because I don't see it like that. I'm pretty sure if someone be tripping like that in the East, it just depends on your environment, but you talked about how, you know, these Mexican women, they fell for the okey-doke when it came to black men. When some of these, their male counterparts, they known for beating on them, treating them like shit, dogging them out and stuff, but they looking at black men like, we worse than that. Not all, but some of them. According to what General Tito was saying on his Patreon, because I'm pretty sure some of these, Spanish shit, they be on that shit too. When they don't want to give a brother a chance. They'll wait till, you know, they either a certain age or done gain a few pounds to give a brother time of day. shit. That's some damn bullshit. I know it's there by some, cause you know, I seen white women, well, white girls coming up in high school. So I'm talking about like the hottest ones, like the top 20, 25 hottest white girls in school. None of them, most of them wouldn't even look at a brother's direction in high school unless, you know, they just wanted that attention, they wanted that validation. Cause I remember this one white chick. A lot of brothers were looking at her because she kind of was thick, bro. She had that ass on her. And she looked and she started smiling because you see all them brothers looking at her. But that's it. That's, she married to a dude, bro, that she's been seeing ever since high school, though. Like senior in high school. I noticed that when some of these white chicks, when they get a little bit older, and they don't have to be in their late 20s, they can be they mid-20s, like 25, 26, then, you know, they'll start giving a brother a chance, but they weren't looking at a brother like that in high school. I mean, it's fucked up, man. This is shit that we have to go through sometimes. But don't take that disrespect. Do not take that disrespect. And something else, don't take disrespect when it comes to being critical of, you know, a lot of these American bimbos out here. Guys want to talk about you making excuses, complaining. They want to act like you're the problem when you're not the problem. That Umar Johnson fool trying to say something about men in this space. He's not going to be the last person. It's going to be more guys that's going to be enemies to the quote-unquote black manosphere. Well, even if you're not part of the black manager, you're just a guy who just wear red pill awareness or thinking black man, you're going to get caught up in that, including if you ask why at the end. I feel like you're going to get included in there, even though SYSBN is not part of the black manosphere. It's still part of the black sector of YouTube. It's still a black sector of YouTube. So by proxy, it might just get included in that. And don't let people gaslight you. Don't let them disrespect you by gaslighting when it comes to self-improvement. Yes, we need to self-improvement, and that's what I'm doing. I'm getting my body right, and I'm getting my credentials right. I'm getting multiple skill sets under my belt as we speak now. I'm out here studying. I'm trying to study 2D and 3D animation, and I'm going to study visual effects and graphic art design. I'm trying to get certificates in all 3Ds. All these entities. Self-improve. You self-improve too. You got self-improved. Get yourself together. Invest. And then when you make your come ups, you give these heifers nothing. You give these bimbos nothing. Like Lionel Mintow said, give them nothing. Take your ball and go. You go to a different environment where it's get appreciated. Get that passport. That's where I'm heading at right now. But this is all I want to say is that, man, don't take disrespect, black man. You deserve better. We deserve better.